In this video, we are going to solve numerical based on inclined venturi meter, where we will calculate discharge of water flowing through venturi meter. So the statement is given as, find discharge of water flowing through the pipe 30 cm diameter placed in an inclined position where a venturi meter is inserted having a throat diameter of 15 cm. The difference of pressure between the main and throat is measured by liquid of specific gravity 0.6 in an inverted U-tube which gives reading of 30 cm. The loss of head between the main and throat is 0.2 times the kinetic head of pipe. To solve this problem, first I will write down the given data provided. Here in this problem, diameter of pipe is given as 30 cm. That is equal to 0.3 meter, which is denoted as small d1, and the throat diameter is given as 15 cm, that is 0.15 meter, which is denoted as small d2. Here specific gravity of manometric liquid, that is oil, is given as 0.6, and the inverted U-tube manometer gives reading of 30 cm, that is x equal to 30 cm, that is 0.3 meter. Here loss of head between main and throat is given as 0.2 times the kinetic head of pipe, which is V1 square upon 2G. In this problem, the water is flowing inside the pipe and we want to find out discharge of water. And we know the formula of discharge, where CD is the coefficient of discharge. But the value of CD is not given in the problem. Hence, we cannot use this formula. But we know that discharge equal to area into velocity. So discharge capital Q equal to A1 V1, where A1 is the area of pipe at section 1, which is pi by 4 D1 square, where D1 value is given as 0.3 meter. And V1 we can calculate by using Bernoulli's equation. So here we apply Bernoulli's equation between section 1 and 2. In order to calculate V1 value, and here we add HL, which is the loss of head between the main and throat, which is given as 0.2 V1 square upon 2G. Here we want to determine V1 value, because with the help of this value, we have to calculate discharge. So for that purpose, to calculate V1, I will first evaluate the remaining values of equation. So here, I will rearrange the equation in order to separate the term P1 minus P2 upon rho g minus Z2 minus Z1, because this part is nothing but the small h, which we can calculate with the help of small x, because small x is the manometric reading given in the problem as 0.3 meter. In this problem, the manometric liquid is oil, which is lighter than the liquid flowing through the pipe, which is water. So the formula of small h will be x into 1 minus specific gravity of lighter liquid upon specific gravity of heavier liquid. Therefore, here small x is 0.3, specific gravity of oil is given as 0.6, and the specific gravity of water is 1. Therefore, I will calculate small h equal to 0.12 meter of water. In this equation, I will put small h equal to 0.12 meter. Now for V2, I will apply continuity equation, that is A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. Here A1 and A2 are the areas of section 1 and 2. So we know that area equal to pi by 4 diameter square, where D1 and D2 are the diameters of section 1 and 2 given in the problem. So I will put these values, and by calculating this, we will get V2 equal to 4V1. Therefore, in the equation, I will replace V2 as 4V1. Now in this equation, the only unknown term is V1. So now we can calculate V1. And here small g is acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.81. Therefore, V1 we got as 0.3988 meter per second. Now, I will put this calculated value of V1 in discharge formula. So by calculating this, we will get discharge of water flowing through the pipe equal to 0.02819 meter cube per second.